This is the second video in a three-part series that helps you get started with Microsoft Azure Backup. Azure Backup is a simple and powerful service that empowers customers to back up Microsoft workloads to Azure. This series will help you back up your Windows servers to Azure. This video will help you with installation of Azure Backup Agent on your production server and registering it with a backup vault. A backup vault on Azure Management Portal is a prerequisite for this video. You also need to have downloaded the Azure Backup Agent and the vault credentials file from the Azure Management Portal. If you haven't done so, please follow the instructions in the previous video to get these files. To begin, execute the Azure Backup Agent installer. You need to select a location for the agent to be installed in and a location to serve as cache for Azure Backup Agent. It is recommended that at least 10% of the data that will be backed up from this production server be allowed as cache space for optimal performance of Azure Backup. In the next screen, you are required to enter proxy settings. If you are behind an authenticated proxy, it's possible that internet connectivity is available through Internet Explorer, but registration of Recovery Services Agent fails if you forget to enter proxy details. Make sure that you enter the correct proxy details here. In the next screen, installer checks for and installs some prerequisites such as .NET Framework and Windows PowerShell. Once these are in place, you are able to proceed seamlessly. Critical updates to Azure Backup are made available through Microsoft Updates, and it's highly recommended that you opt into this service if you haven't already done so. Once the installer completes installation, you can proceed to registration by clicking on the Proceed to Register button. In this screen, you need to provide the installer with the vault credentials file. If you don't have this file, please follow the instructions in the previous video to download it. You can now review the vault credentials details and proceed to the next screen. The encryption settings screen will ask you to provide a passphrase. This passphrase is used to encrypt your data in transit and at rest in Microsoft Azure. In case you lose this key, backup data cannot be retrieved. Note that Microsoft has no knowledge of this key and you are the sole owner of this key. It's highly recommended that you save the passphrase to a file and secure it in an off-site location. Once you've entered encryption settings, you're able to finish installation of the Azure Backup Agent. This is the end of this video. The next video will demonstrate backing up and restoring files from your production server to Microsoft Azure. Thanks for watching.